Hello, here we are again with Mookie Tenembaum. We are exploring through these videos his disillusionism, his misalgic theory about human behavior. And we come now to a second video in a short series. There's a previous one already up, addressing the structure that explains human behavior with a comparison of sorts, a metaphor, in which three computers are introduced. We spoke about the first of these computers in the previous video. There will be a third video for a third computer, but now we are going to focus in the second computer, in this sort of network that explains how we behave. So, Mookie on his second computer hypothesis.
Well, again, before we go into the second computer, let me remind everybody, it's computer number one. It's the animal in us, the one that has only now and here. And there is computer number two, the one I'm going to talk about, which is both the self-awareness computer and the one that can foresee or tries to foresee the future. And then there is computer number three, the one that is our moral judgments, the one that is behind guilty feelings. Okay? Today we're going to speak about computer number two. As I said before, computer number one has today, now, here, that's it. Computer number two has two different areas. The one is self-awareness. We can imagine, and of course, I'm not saying that that's exactly how it happened, that at some point this animal grew inside of its brain a branch or a process that is computer number two, and suddenly it discovered itself. It was self-aware. It was able to see itself from a mirror, from the outside, but it's from the inside. So it is the one computer that allows us to suffer, allows us, well, that makes us, that is behind suffering, yes? It is the one that makes pain a suffering. It is the one that, because it tries to foresee the future, it's behind fear. It is behind fear and being scared, not just fear, yes? It's being scared about the future. So how does it, computer number two, with the future? How does it work? It takes the memory. It works with the memory. The memory is like its bank account. Yes, it draws from the memory all the time, and it tries to foresee the future. That foreseeing of the future works like this. It sends. It's like a probe. Like you send a probe, and this is of course a simile, and that probe has a long line, a long cable. Yes, to the future, and from the future the probe has very little bandwidth, so it sends only a few photographs from the future. I'll give an example. Let's say next Tuesday I want to take a ride with the boat. I want to ride the boat. And this is an idea of number two already. Yes, number one has no Tuesday. There is no Tuesday for number one. There is no Tuesday, there is no Monday, there is no January, there is no Christmas, there is no birthday, nothing. For computer number one, may I remind you, has really three basic questions. Can I eat it? Does it hurt? Can I have sex with it? Those are the three questions that may computer number one has. Number two, of course, has a lot of questions. So what it does is, as I say again, it goes to next Tuesday and it looks at the forecast and it says, well, it looks like we have a good weather. So that could be a great idea to sit in a boat and enjoy the sun and the weather and blah, blah. So it sends back the pictures back to number one. Yes, and it shows little moments where you see it very nice and the sun is hitting you and sprints of water, you know, and sprinkles and everything. I don't know, I don't like to ride boats. So but you know, you enjoy sitting in a chair. And that's what it comes out as it's a forecast. Of course, it's very incomplete. It does not remind you that you will have to drive 2 hours to the port and then find the guy who is in charge of the boat, and then get to see the boat if the boat is clear, and if it works, and if the outboard motor works, and then you remember that the chair you left there is not good enough. I mean, the whole thing that happens when you really go into the boat, that doesn't happen. Number two, cannot foresee it and will not foresee it because that's not how it works. Okay, so there will be a moment in which number one will have to sit in a chair that is not so comfortable. Number one will be in pain. Number two will suffer. The whole thing will happen just to understand how, what is the way it behaves. What do you think about that, Florence?
I perfectly see how this self-awareness, being able to understand what's to come, has an influence on the behavior of what you call computer number one. But I wanted to ask you if there are instances in which there conflict arises between the two, in which, as if it were, computer number one would pull in one direction and computer number two in another. And what happens there?
A very good example is a vaccine. Yes, computer number two says we have to go to have a vaccine so we don't get sick. There is no way computer number one will agree to anything as a prick on your hand. It won't work. You know, you're an animal. Have you ever tried to vaccinate an animal? Believe me, it never shows gratitude when you do that, because it will not get the rabies. Yes? You will not see it, nor will us do it. Yes? A baby is a pure animal. Mm-hmm. There is no computer mm-hmm. number two working there until he's probably 2 or 3 years or 1.5 years. We don't know exactly when, but there is no computer number two working at all. So it's not computer number one. There is no way you can tell a baby, stop, this is good for you. So there is a conflict, but computer number one and computer number two work on a trust basis, because probably most of the times computer number two forecasts things and computer number one said no, the consequences that computer number one had to bear, it shows them, it learned to trust computer number two. It just trusted. So that trust, of course, sometimes you don't, because you are very bad at your computer number two is bad at forecasting, and then you have a conflict. But normally you would say okay, and it will take the pain, depending on the age. Yes, the older you are, the more you trust your computer number two, until again, nobody likes, please give me I love the feeling of being punctured by a needle. that will never happen, probably. No.
Very good. So in the next video, we will address the third computer, but I think one and two are nearly covered, at least at an introductory level. Thank you very much.
If you enjoyed the video, please like it, comment, and subscribe.